If you see, this is the GT matrix score of a website that I have created. This is an e-commerce website and you can see this score is so bad. The page speed score is F and it is giving only 35%. F is the worst score. Y slow score is E, 55%, and it is taking around 5 seconds to fully load. Okay, which is quite good considering this score. And the total file size is 2.65 MB and requests are so many. So if you follow my steps, you can achieve something like this. You know, the page speed has gone to A instead of F. Y slow score has gone to 83%, which is awesome. And it is taking only 2.8 seconds to fully load the website. The page size is also reduced and requests are also reduced. Now don't forget that this is not an ordinary website. This is an e-commerce website. It is using a lot of space. You know, it is using a lot of heavy plugins like WooCommerce and so. And there are many different big images which are used over here. Like if you see over here, if you can see this image in the slider. So this is a very heavy website. And in spite of that, we have achieved such a good numbers over here. So this is what you can achieve. And if you're creating just a simple blog or a simple business website, your results will be much better. Now, why is this happens? Why these websites are so heavy and the score is so bad? So by default, WordPress is based on PHP, which is not a very light language. And also because people use a lot of unnecessary plugins. Your website might become very heavy and take a lot of time for the website to load. And ultimately, you might get those 100% CPU usage errors. So to fix those problems, it is very necessary to have a caching plugin installed and configured properly, which is exactly what we are going to do in today's video. Now, if you're new to this channel, consider subscribing. If you have already done that, then click on that bell icon so that you don't miss any future videos. Give a thumbs up to this video if you find this helpful. Leave a comment if you find any doubt. If you have any queries, any suggestions for me, you can leave them in the comment section below. Now let's get into it. Now the first thing that we have to do is go to our dashboard. And here obviously first we have to install the plugins. So hover plugins and click on add new. And as I said you earlier, we'll be using W3 Total Cache. Now there are many different caching plugins, but I think at present W3 Total Cache is a really good one. So in the search plugins, you can type in W3 Total Cache or you can just type W3, you'll see the result. So this is the one that we have to install. As you can see, it has got more than 1 million active installs, which is really crazy. More than 3,800 reviews. And you can see it has got 4.5, which is an awesome review. So let's install this plugin. After installing, make sure to activate the plugin. Alright, so once installed and activated, you'll see this performance tab at the left hand side. So when you hover this, you'll see there are many different options available over here. So what we have to do, we have to go to this option, general settings. Now under general settings at the top, you'll see there are few links. These will redirect you to different sections under the general settings. Now if you go to minify, it will redirect you to this minify section and so on. Now the first option under this general setting is preview mode, which I think is a very important option, especially if you're creating and doing these steps on a live website and if your website is getting a decent amount of visitor. So in the middle of time, in just, you know, your website is live and in the middle of that you're doing these changes. So sometimes some changes which I'll explain you later in this video might break your site. It doesn't make your it doesn't mean that your website will go offline or something like that, but it will break the CSS, which is the style, and you will see only, you know, the text and images and so on, which looks very bad. So to avoid these things, this preview mode is enabled. When you enable this thing, when you click on this enable button, it will reload, and after that you will get three different buttons: disable, deploy and preview. Now what happens is, suppose you want to enable this page cache, okay? So once we enable this page cache, we save settings and purge caches. Now once preview mode is enabled, in this case, as you can see, it is enabled right now. So these changes will not take place. We can preview the changes, and if everything is fine, then we can click on this deploy button. So it will deploy the changes on the live website. But until and unless we click on this deploy, all the changes that we do will not take effect. So this is a very important setting, and I hope you understand what I mean by that. Okay, so next setting that we have, okay, let me first disable it. Okay, so we don't need this at present. This is just for tutorial purposes. So we don't need this right now. All right, so next option is page cache. Now this is the most important option in the entire plugin. If you don't do any settings at all and just enable, just tick mark this option, this will improve the performance to a very great extent. This will boost the performance to a really measurable amount. Okay, so you can just by clicking on this, just by enabling one single option, you will see a great amount of improvement in your website performance. So just enable this thing and click on save settings and purge caches. All right, so now let's come back over here and there's a method, page cache method, and by default this disk enhanced will be selected and you have to select this one. Okay, disk enhanced. You have this disk basic, don't select that one. And if you're using a dedicated server or VPS or something like that, then you can select these options. You can, okay, so but for most of you guys, because most of the people use the shared hosting, so you have to select this one, disk enhanced. After that, the next option we have is minification. This will minify the CSS and JavaScript file. So to do so, just click on that enable button. And when you click on that enable button, it will tell you that if you enable this, this might break your website. So we just click on this. I understand the risk. Now there are two options in the minify mode, auto and manual. For most of you people, just select auto. If everything goes fine on your website, nothing happens, then you can stay with auto. You can stick with auto. After minifying, after enabling this minification and auto, if your website breaks, you can click on manual and we can do the settings further. Okay. Now in the minify cache method, make sure disk is selected. HTML minifier should be, all these three options should be the same, which is the default option. So let's save settings and purge cache. Now let me do one thing. Let me open my website in a new tab. Let's see whether everything is working fine or not. All right, so everything looks good. Let me open this website in a new incognito window, because sometimes you might see the website is looking good over there, but when you see the incognito window, sometimes the website is broken. So there's nothing happening over here. Everything looks quite good. All right, so let's come back over here to the settings. Okay, so we have done with the minification setting. Now after that, we have this opcode cache and it is by default enabled, so we don't have to do anything. Simply click on save settings and purge caches. All right, now after that, we have this database cache. Now you have to be very careful with this one. What I would recommend you, first enable this, click on save settings and purge cache, and see the performance. If you go to GT Metrics and type in the or paste in your website URL, if you see that the performance is improved, then you can stay with this. If enabling this option is degrading the performance, then you can simply disable this. Now, because you know database caching is a resourceful, you know, it takes a lot of resources, server resources, and most of the shared hosting does not provide that. Okay, so sometimes this might slow down your website as well. So be very careful with this one. Obviously it will not break down your website, but it might slow down. Okay, so let's click on save settings and purge caches. Now one thing we have to notice and one thing you have to remember, that the most important thing in the website performance and speed is the hosting that you choose. And that's why I have given my top three hosting that I recommend, that I personally use. I have given the links in the video description below. You can see those hostings and make sure to select any three or any one of those three hosting accounts. Okay. Those are the fastest, the best, and they have the better support. They are secure and all the options are available over there. Okay, so most important setting and most important option in improving the performance and speed of your website is choosing the perfect hosting. If you have selected a hosting like HostGator, GoDaddy, Bluehost, now those hostings are not at all good, because now those companies are owned by some conglomerate, you know, they have many different, they are buying all the hosting companies, and to increase their profit, they are reducing the resources and they are, you know, reducing the support staff, which is not a good idea. So if you're using, or if your website is based on HostGator, Bluehost and GoDaddy like of host servers, I would recommend you to migrate to the top three hosting providers that I have given link in the video description below. Now, after that, we have this object cache. Now, for most of the people, I would recommend you to just leave this option. We don't want to enable this because this is not going to improve the performance of your website. And this is recommended for, you know, high end people who are using VPS servers and very expensive servers. So we just leave this thing. Don't listen to anything. Just leave this thing. Then after that, we have browser cache. Now, this is one of the most important option. This is a really important option. Now, what this does is, suppose a person comes to your website for the first time. So when this thing is enabled, what this browser, whatever browser the person is using, like Chrome or Mozilla Firefox, whatever it is they are using, this browser will cache the entire website for them. Okay. So if you go to your settings, let me show you, if you're using Chrome, if you go to settings, okay, let me show you one thing. Let's scroll down. Let's go to advanced and let's search for, here it is, clear browsing data. So when you click on that, you'll see something called cached images and files. And for me, it is 300 MB. For you, it might be less or more. So this is all the cached images and files of different websites that I visit. Now, when this thing happens, when the person visits your website for the second time, third time, fourth time, then what happens is the website performance will be very, very fast because the website is not getting the data from the server, but it is getting the data from your, not the data, I would say, but they are getting the cached file from your browser. Okay, so that makes a website very, very fast. So if you don't understand that, don't worry, just make this enable. Now I should tell you this, guys, that if you don't understand what I am saying, if you don't understand this caching process and so on, don't worry, just follow my step. Whatever I tick mark, you tick mark. Whatever button I click, you click on that button and you will see a great amount of improvement in your website. Okay. So once you enable this, simply click on save settings and purge caches. Alright, now the next option over here is CDN. Now, I highly recommend using a CDN and something like Mac CDN and so on. But that does, that will obviously cost you some money, a very small amount of money, but some money. Okay. So in this video, we are not covering this and there is a free CDN available that is Cloudflare. So this is the first episode of this series. In the next episode, I will cover Cloudflare. So if you're watching this video and whenever that second video comes, make sure to watch that because that will boost your website performance furthermore. Okay. So at present, we are leaving this section because once we use Cloudflare, we'll have to, you know, do some changes later on. Now, reverse proxy, you have to just leave this thing because this is some technical stuff and you have to, you know, install Varnish and do all this technical stuff in your server. So let's leave this thing. Then after that, we have monitoring. So what happens is, suppose if you want to use this, this is actually something that is not at all required because just leave this thing as well. Okay. Now fragment cache, you can select this. You can select this disk and click on save settings and purge caches. All right. Now let's come down. Let's see what is left over here. Monitoring, fragment cache. Now, if you're using a pro version, if you have purchased the pro version of W3 Total Cache, this is where you will enter your license key for the pro version. Now, we are using a free version, which is more than enough. And I think the performance is really great. So we don't need a pro version over here. Now, some more settings, enable Google page speed dashboard. Now, if you want to enable this, what happens is if you go to your dashboard, there are many widgets available by default. So these are all different widgets at a glance, quick draft, activity. So if you enable this, this thing, Google page speed dashboard, you will see another widget over here. So for that, you will have to get an API and so on, which is not recommended. That is not useful because we can track these data from Google Analytics. Okay. So this is not required. All right. Now you don't have to do anything over here. Nothing is more important over here. Just tick mark this thing, optimized disk enhanced page and minified disk caching for NFS because at the bottom it says, you know, you might see some possible performance improvement. So just for that sake, let's tick mark this and click on save settings and purge caches. Alright guys, so we are done with the general settings. Now for most of you guys, you don't even have to watch the next part of the video wherein we go in detail and see all these options related to all different options. For example, we have page cache over here. So this was just enabling it and it will, you know, make all the default settings. But if you want to play around with some more settings, you can open this more advanced form and you can see and you can tweak some more settings from there. Okay, so but if you do only this much, you should be okay with that. Okay, just make sure to see that your website is running good and nothing is happening. Let's open our website again in a new incognito window. Let's see whether everything is fine over here. Alright, so everything looks fine over here. So let's come back to our website. Now let's do all these settings. So first let's click on page cache. The first option over here is cache front page. So do you want to cache your front page? Obviously we do want to cache our front page. So make sure this thing is tick mark over here. Do you want to cache the feed, site, categories, comments? Yes, we want to cache them as well. Now cache SSL HTTPS request. Now for this you might require this SSL certificate. So if you have SSL certificate over here, which is the secure socket, you can simply tick mark this thing. Now leave this thing cache URIs and leave this as well, cache 404 pages. We don't want to cache that because people hardly see those pages and we don't want to cache a 404 page. Why would you do that? That is a not found page. Whenever someone is searching on your website for something, they don't find it, they see the 404 page. So we don't want to cache that. Also make sure this thing is tick marked, don't cache pages for logged in users. Now why is that important? Because if you're logged in, if you're making some changes to your website, for example, if you're changing the design of your homepage and if you see the preview, you'll see that the design has not changed. Now that is because of caching. You are seeing the cached version or the, you can see the history version of the page that you created earlier. Okay, so that page is cached, that page is saved and you're seeing that page, you're not seeing the revised or updated version. You'll see that version after some time. Okay, so we don't want to do that. You know, we want to see the fresh version. Okay, so make sure this thing is tick mark over here. Now, after that, we have aliases. If you have different websites, different domain names redirecting to the same website, you can type in those domain names over here. Each domain name will come to a fresh line. Then after that, we have cache preload. Make sure to tick mark this thing. So do you want to cache the page before, cache the website or the page before it loads? So if you don't understand that, don't worry. Just leave the settings to default and tick mark this. Just one setting is required over here, which is the sitemap URL. Now, if you're using Yoast SEO, which is a free plugin, very good plugin, I highly recommend you to use that plugin. So what you can do is you can go to your website, type in your website URL, whatever it is, and after that put a forward slash and type in sitemap-index.xml. Okay, so make sure to type in your website name forward slash sitemap-index.html and press enter. Now you should see this page, and as you can see, this page is generated by Yoast SEO. So what you have to do, you have to simply copy this code from here, come over here and paste this link over here and tick mark this thing, preload the post cache upon publish events and click on save settings and purge caches. After that, we have this setting, purge policy, page cache. So what are the different pages that you want to cache? Okay, so we want to cache the front page, the post pages, the blog feed and RSS to default. Okay, so just leave these settings to default. Don't tick mark anything over here. Just leave these things to default and purge limit, make sure it is 10. Now in the advanced thing, you don't have to do anything at all. Just don't touch anything over here. Now let's go to minify. Alright, so first option is general option and the first over here is rewrite URL structure. So make sure this thing is enabled, because if it is not enabled, then it will use this get variables, which is not a good idea. We want the normal structure to be used, not these get variables. So make sure this thing is tick mark over here. Now, next option is disable minify for logged in users. Don't tick mark this thing, because if you tick mark this thing, what happens is the two files will be created, a normal CSS file and a minified CSS file. And people, the user, the visitor on your website will be served the minified version and you will be served the normal version. We don't want that. We just want the simple minified version. So make sure this thing is unticked. Now, if you get some minification error notification, where do you want them to be sent? So admin notification, email notification, both admin and email notification. If you select email notification, I think it will send you email to the email address that you have used to while creating this website. All right. Then after that, we have HTML and XML. Now make sure to enable this and enable this one, CSS minification, inline JavaScript minification, and the fourth one, line break removal. After you do this, click on save settings and purge cache. This is all minification, so it will minify CSS, it will minify JavaScript, and it will remove all the line breaks which are present. Now again, after doing these settings, go to incognito window and make sure everything is working fine. All right, so in this case everything is working fine, so we can just move forward. If you see some problem over there, what you can do, you can untick this CSS minification, then click on save settings and purge cache, then go in the incognito window and see whether everything is working fine or not. Okay, so that is how it is done. If you can try to untick this thing and then go to your website and see whether everything is working fine or not. But don't worry, nothing happens. Everything mostly works fine. In very rare cases, your website will break. So just don't worry about that. Now, ignored common stems. So make sure to not delete this. Okay, so just leave this thing as it is, because we have some Google ads and all these things. We don't want these things to be removed. Okay. Now under JavaScript minification, don't do anything. Just make sure it is enable and minify. Don't click on this thing, combine only. If you click on that, what happens is there are many different JavaScript files, so it will just combine it, but it will not minify it. When we select minify, it will both combine it and minify it. So make sure it is enabled and minified. Now you can click on this save settings and purge caches after that. Now, after that, we have this CSS minification. Make sure it is enabled. And line break removal is also enabled. Okay, so just enable the first one and the line break removal one. And again, you don't have to, don't click on this one, combine only. If you click on this one, again, the same thing will happen. Different CSS files will be combined, but they won't be minified. And if you just enable this, they will be combined and minified both. Okay, so make sure to enable the first one and the fourth one, which is enable and line break removal, and after that click on save settings. Then again, after that we have advanced settings. Now just like the page cache, leave the advanced settings. Okay, now let's go to database cache. Okay, so in the database cache, first you have don't cache queries for logged in users, which is fine. And in the advanced, again, we don't have to touch the advanced section. So leave that thing. We don't have to see the object cache because we have not enabled it. Simply go to browser cache. Now in this one, tick mark all these things that I'm doing. Okay. All right. Okay. Till here. So first one is set last modified header. Make sure this thing is tick mark. Okay. So a second one is set expires header. Tick mark this as well. Then tick mark this, set cache control header, set entity tag, e tag, set w3 total cache header, enable gzip compression, and prevent caching of objects after setting change. Okay, so tick mark all these things, come at the top bottom and click on save settings and purge cache. Then come at the bottom and we have CSS and JavaScript. And again over here, make sure all these things at the top is tick mark. Okay, the set last modified header is the same settings, set expired header, cache head control header, and e tag, gzip, all these things are enabled. And only one thing is disabled over here, which is remove query strings from static resources. So this is a good default setting. So don't do anything. Simply click on save settings and purge cache. Then after that, we have the HTML and XML. Again, make sure everything is enabled over here. You can simply copy my settings. Okay. Whatever you see enabled, make it enabled or tick mark. If you see anything untick, just untick that thing. Okay. Then media and other files also, everything is enabled over here. Okay. You can see all these things is enabled except for this thing, remove query strings from static resources. Just this is in disabled, rest everything is enabled. Now rest everything you don't have to worry about. So once you do this much changes, you should see a great amount of difference and improvement in your website performance and speed. Now we have not done, I have not clicked on most of the saved settings pages, but still let me do one thing. Let me copy this, go to GT Matrix. Okay, so let's go to GT Matrix. Let me paste in this website and let's see the result now. Let's analyze it. Let me fast forward this for you. All right, now as you can see, we have a crazy amount of difference over here. The page speed is 98%. Voice load is 97%. Now this is much better as compared to this one because it is just a simple fresh installation and we just have one demo post, hello world. That's why you see so better results. Now you can furthermore improve the performance of your website. Now if your website is very heavy, you might not see this good result. You will see something like this, but you can improve this course as well. Now in the furthermore episodes of this series, what after creating a WordPress website, that is what we are calling it right now. So in this series, in the next episode, we'll cover Cloudflare. Make sure to watch that video. So Cloudflare will improve your website performance to a great extent. Then after that, we'll do a video on maybe, I think we'll cover iTheme security just to make your website secure. And then after that, I will cover or I'll create a new episode on image caching and image compression and optimization. Now that is also very, very important thing, especially considering the website speed and performance. So that is a very important thing because there are many different images which I used on a website. And you know, those images sometimes are quite big images and we want to optimize them and compress them. We want to reduce the size of the image, but you know, keeping the quality same. So that is what we are going to learn in further more videos. Now, if you don't want to miss those videos, make sure to subscribe and click on that bell icon. If you like this video, give a thumbs up. If you dislike it, you know what to do. If you have any doubt, any comments, any queries, any suggestions for me, you can leave them in the comment section below. Thanks a lot for watching, guys. See you soon.